Good morning to all of you. Welcome to the free lecture series on the electrical meter. Here now we are going to discuss the methods to improve commutation. In the previous lecture, we have learned about how the commutation failure occurs because of this current reversal during the commutation section. Here during commutation, the current reverses from plus 5 to 0, from 0 to minus 5. There is a change in current which generates a reactance voltage in the coil, and this reactance voltage may generate a huge circulating current in the coil. As a result, the current, the insulation breakdown, the mica insulation breakdown, air gap becomes ionized, and as a result, a huge current fire, ring fire occurs in this coil which is undergoing commutation. So in order to improve this, to reduce this reactance voltage, we need a phenomenon that is called methods to improve commutation technique. So there are three methods to improve the commutation technique. The first one is called resistance commutation. Second is called voltage commutation, and this part there are two types: using interpoles, using brush sheet. Using interpole is widely used, brush sheet is not used because there is some drawbacks that we have to go discuss in the later class, but at that time we have to move toward the resistance commutation. To improve the commutation, that is to make the current reversal faster, time constant is decreased by increasing the resistance. So carbon brushes are used, and other advantage is it has less deterioration occurs. But it means that we have to reverse the current at this point. This is our coil, and like this fashion, if we are making this brushes of carbon, it is L upon R, tau equals to L upon R. If the resistance is increases, then the time constant is decreased, then the current which is coming out from this brushes is easily available. So we are using the carbon brushes. Carbon is having a property that it's having a high resistance. So resistance is increases, the time constant of system is decreases, so the current reversal is faster. So this is the one option that we can easily understood, that we can decrease, decrease the time constant by increasing the resistance using the carbon brushes. Second thing that which is very useful and understandable, it is called using interpoles. As per the name suggests, voltage commutation, we are having a reactance voltage generated in the coil, and we have to eliminate this. So we have to need an extra voltage that will eliminate this reactance voltage that we are calling as a voltage commutation. So in the voltage commutation, we are using interpoles and using brush. So first we are going to discuss using interpoles. This is using interpoles. To neutralize the reactance voltage, interpoles are the poles provided along Q axis or commutator axis. They provide the magnetic field which generate an induced EMF that will neutralize the reactance voltage and improve commutation. What do you mean by this? This is the poles. The interpoles, at the term the poles, it is also interpole. This is a pole which will be along Q axis. This is called the Q axis. Here there are two axes. This is called the D axis. We are using the direct axis called the flux axis. The axis which is along the flux is called direct axis, and the axis which is perpendicular to the D axis called Q axis. The definition shows that the interpoles are the poles which is provided along Q axis. So there are the pole which is called Q axis. Here we are given two interpole windings like this fashion, because there is a reversal of current is take place from this side to this side. So interpoles are the small poles that will be provided along Q axis, and it will, since the coil is moving by an external prime mover, this will generate a flux, giving a flux which will generate a flux in the coil. This flux basically like this fashion, this interpole which giving a flux in the armature. Since the armature is moving by an external prime mover, it will generate a flux called interpole flux. It is called interpole flux, and we try to eliminate this reactance voltage. That means we can say that we have to be thinking about like this. Let us suppose this is basically this. Basically, you can say that the interpole flux, and this is basically the reactance voltage generated. Similarly, at this conductor section, these are basically plus, and this is minus. So, this is the plus minus, this is plus minus, this is plus minus, this is plus minus. This is the reactance voltage that is generated. This is the reactance voltage generated in the coil A dash, in the coil this is A, and this is the interpole voltage. This is the interpole voltage, and magnitude of the interpole voltage should be equal to the reactance voltage. If it is possible, then we can say that the interpole voltage should be zero. Here the current is like this fashion, here the current is like this fashion, so it will be eliminated. Similarly, the current is leaving, its limit will be eliminated. The concept is very simple. The interpole windings are basically the windings that is placed along the Q axis, and it will generate the induced flux called interpole flux or interpole induced EMF that is nearly equal to the reactance voltage should be zero. So this interpole axis is very important. It can be easily understand that the interpoles are connected in series with the armature. That means the flux which is coming from this side, it is also connected to this interpole winding, and something like the connection like this fashion. Moving toward this. So interpole windings are also having a wire which is connected in series with this armature winding, and it's coming from the brushes like this fashion. So interpoles are the poles which are connected in series, and it is always try to generate an induced EMF which will eliminate this reactance voltage that will house, that will generate a huge current. This is the one concept that we understand called interpole winding. Since sometimes we have seen that the structure of interpole winding like this fashion, since in order to avoid the saturation, this is like this fashion. This is called interpole winding. So sometimes we have seen that these are the actual construction of interpole winding like this fashion. To avoid this saturation here, so we are just changing the shape of the pole like this. So sometimes we will say books, this kind of the shape will be there. Okay. Now move on to the next important part. It is called giving the brush shift. In the process of brush shift, moving in the direction of generation of the motor, of the more the direction of generation of direction of sorry, it is. Generator. If the process, the brush shift is moving in the direction of generator, the induced EMF in the coil will change to the polarity of the pole ahead before it reaches the brush axis. What is the meaning of this line? This is the important line that we have to understand to make the concept of improving commutation. So there will be induced EMF in the coil undergoing commutation, and they reduce the generation of reactance voltage, but the technique is not widely used. That it means, let us remove this to not be used. This is our north pole and this is our south pole. It is remains stationary always, north pole and south pole. We are giving the brush shift. Brush shift means like this. This is brush shift. We are giving a brush shift of some angle like this, theta. If I put the conductors like this fashion, we have already understand this is the conductors are putting. Okay. And the current is reverses in the conductors when it crosses the brush axis. So this is cross, this is cross. This is cross, this is cross, this is cross, this is cross, this is dot, 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 dot. Since we are giving the brush shift, so under the influence of this south pole, this conductor will generate a current in the opposite direction. So the thing is that Here the current reversal will not be possible because of this conductor will not cross the brush axis. Here this conductor should not be a dot because it should be a dot when it crosses the brush axis. But since we are giving a shift to the brush, this conductor is under the influence of south, so it will generate an induced EMF in the opposite direction. Whenever the reactance voltage will be there, so this conductor is responsible to eliminate this reactance voltage because it is under the influence of the south. It should be a dot, but it is cross. So this cross will generate a current. It is called induced current, which will eliminate the reactance voltage. This is the basic concept regarding the brush shift. So I was just already written here that the induced EMF is generated in coil which change to the polarity of the pole ahead before it reaches the brush axis. It will change the polarity, and whenever the reactance voltage will be generated, it will automatically eliminate it. So this is the concept of this methods to improve computation. I think you will enjoy this, and the next class we will discuss about the armature reaction.